बॉयस दिस इज सिविक्स सेकेंड लेसन सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट। इंट्रोडक्शन द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट इज द सुप्रीम गवर्नमेंट इन अवर कंट्री। विच इज द सुप्रीम गवर्नमेंट इन अवर कंट्री? यस सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट इज द सुप्रीम गवर्नमेंट इन अवर कंट्री। द हेडक्वार्टर ऑफ द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट इज अट न्यू डेल्ही। सो वेर इज द हेडक्वार्टर्स लोकेटेड? New Delhi. Articles 52 to 78 in Part 5 of Indian Constitution deals with the Union Executive. The makers of the Indian Constitution, by giving due recognition to the vastness and plural character of our nation, have provided a federal arrangement for her governors. What is the meaning for makers of the Indian Constitution? Creators of the Indian Constitution, giving due recognition into vastness and plural character and federal arrangement for her governors. Our central government consists of three wings: Executive, Legislature and Judiciary. The Union Executive consists of the President of India, the Vice President and the Council of Ministers headed by the President and the Attorney General of India. Okay, our Executive consists of the President of India, Vice President, Prime Minister, Council of Minister and Attorney General. Next, we are going to see about legislature. The legislature is known as the parliament. Legislature is nothing but what? Parliament. It consists of two houses. What are the two houses? Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Rajya Sabha is nothing but upper house. Lok Sabha is nothing but lower house. Judiciary. So, what is the real name for the judiciary? Supreme Court of India. So judiciary is nothing but Supreme Court of India. So under this Supreme Court, one Chief Justice is there and other 27 judges are there. Okay. The President of India. The President is the nominal executive authority. So, real head of our nation is the President. The Chief Executive of the Indian Union is the President. So, who is the Chief Executive of our Indian country? Yes, the President. He is designated as the first citizen of India. So, what is the qualification of the President? He is designated as the first citizen. Our President is otherwise called as the first citizen of India. He is the supreme commander of the armed forces. What is the meaning for armed forces? Army forces. The President is also the constitutional head of the Union Executive. According to Article 53 of the Constitution, the executive power of the Union shall be vested in the President, which shall be exercised by him directly or through officers subordinated to him in accordance with Constitution. So this is nothing but our country's real head is President. According to Article 53, the executive power is the President. Okay, qualification for the election as the President: he should be a citizen of India, he must have completed the age of 35 years. So above 35 years completed persons only elected for the President. Okay, he must not hold any office of profit under the Union, state or local government. He must not do these kind of jobs in Union government, state government and local government. Okay, he should have the other qualifications required to become a member of the Lok Sabha. So He must have a other qualification. What is the other qualification? Member of the Lok Sabha. His or her name should be proposed by at least 10 electors and seconded by another 10 electors. Electors means what? Electorates. Okay. Of the electoral college which elects the president. The president cannot be a member of parliament or of a state legislature. He must not be a member of parliament or member of a state legislature. If he is a member of any legislature, his seat will be deemed to have been vacated on the date he or she assumes the office of president. What is the meaning for deemed? Considered. Okay. It is a well-known fact that the President of India resides at Rashtrapati Bhavan in New Delhi. So, our President is in Rashtrapati Bhavan. Rashtrapati Bhavan is situated in New Delhi. The residence and the office of the President are located in the same building. The house and the office of the President are located in the same building. However, he has two other offices. Come residences where he conducts office at least once a year. They are the retreating building at Shimla and the Rashtrapati Nilayam at Hyderabad. These locations, one in north and other one is south. So, except this Rashtrapati Bhavan, President has another two residing houses also. So, what are they? The retreat building at Shimla and the Rashtrapati Nilayam at Hyderabad. These locations, one in north and other in south. So, it symbolizes the unity of the country and unity of the diverse culture of the people. So, this indicates the unity of our Indian country. Election of the President. The President is elected by an electoral college in accordance with the system of proportional representation by means a single transferable vote. So, what is the meaning for single transferable vote? One member only. So, that is only called single transferable vote. The electoral college. What is an electoral college? This electoral college consists of the elected members of both houses of the parliament. So, how many houses in parliament we have? Lower house and upper house. So, members of both houses of the parliament and elected members of the states and elected members of national capital territory of Delhi and Puducherry. Once elected as the president, has to take an oath of office before the Chief Justice of India. He must be taken oath before our Chief Justice of India. The President is elected for a term of 5 years and can be re-elected. So, the President is elected for a term of 5 years. How many years? 5 years. Powers of the President. Executive powers. Article 77 requires that every executive action of the Union shall be taken in the name of the President. He appoints the Prime Minister and other members of the Council of Ministers, distributing portfolios to them on the advice of the Prime Minister. President only elected all ministers including Prime Minister. He is responsible for making a wide variety of appointments. So, he also responsible for the wide variety of appointments. So, many types of appointments. These include the appointment of the Governor of States, Chief Justice and other judges of Supreme Court and High Courts, the Attorney General, the Comptroller and Auditor General, the Chief Election Commissioner and other election commissioners and chairman and other members of the Union Public Service Commission, ambassadors and high commissioners to other countries. So, these all members appointed by the President with the permission of the Prime Minister. Okay. So, next we are going to see about legislative powers. He inaugurates the session of the parliament by addressing it after the general election and also at the beginning of the first session each year. He conducts the session of the parliament, a first session in each year. Okay, this address is essentially identical in nature to a speech from a throne. The president summons parliament at least twice in a year. The president gives summon to the parliament at least how many years gap? Twice in a year. So every year two times he has to give a summon to the parliament. He may send messages to either house of the parliament with respect to a bill pending in the house. So what is the money bill? This money bill is nothing but money bill contains tax, borrow of money, expenditure, consolidated money and consolidated funds. Okay, these are all called money bills. So all bills passed by the parliament become laws of acts only after getting assent of the president. Only after getting president permissions only these all bills passed by the parliament. Money bills cannot be introduced in the parliament without his approval. So without president approvals, money bill cannot be introduced in the parliament. President terminates the session of both or any of the houses of the parliament. What is the meaning for terminate? Stop. President stops the session of both or any of the houses of parliament. He can even dissolve the Lok Sabha before the expiry of the term of the house. So what is the meaning for the dissolve? Dismiss. Okay, he nominates 12 persons who are eminent in literature, science, sports, art, social service to the Rajya Sabha. So he nominates 12 persons. The 12 persons are talented in literature, science, sports, art, social service. Okay, he can also nominate 2 persons belonging to Anglo-Indian community to the Lok Sabha. Financial powers. Annual budget of the central government is presented before the Lok Sabha by Union Finance Minister only with the permission of the President. So annual budget is presented before the Lok Sabha only after getting President permission. He causes to be laid before the Parliament the annual financial statement. So annual financial statement is nothing but Union budget, okay, general budget. The Constitution of India places the Contingency Fund of India is at the disposal of the President. So what is the meaning for Contingency Fund? Fund for urgency. Okay, that is only called Contingency Fund. Disposal means what? Distribution. Okay, no demand for a grant can be made except on his recommendation. He can make advances out of Contingency Fund of India to meet any unexpected expenditure. So any unexpected expenditure situation held in India, President may use these contingency funds. He constitutes a finance commission after every 5 years. He conducts a finance commission after every 5 years. Judicial powers. Article 72 confers on the President power to grant pardons, reprieves, respites or remissions of punishment or to commute the sentence of any person convicted of an offence. What is the meaning for pardon? Forgiven or error. Okay, what is the meaning for reprieve? Punishment. What is the meaning for commute? Reduce. So, the President may forgive an error, may have a power of forgive an error, forgive a punishment and commute means what? Reduce. Reduce the sentence of any person convicted of an offense. So reduce the prisoner's crime. Okay. For example, 20 years to 5 years, 50 years to 10 years. So this is only called reduce the prisoner's crime. Military powers. Article 53 lays down the Supreme Court command of the defense force of the Union shall be vested in the President and the exercise thereof shall be regulated by the law. So Article 53 says that the supreme command of the defense force. So who is the supreme commander of the defense force? Yes, the president. Union shall be vested in the president. So and the exercise thereof shall be regulated by the law. So who is the head? President. So these are military powers regulated by law. Okay, diplomatic powers. The president appoints Indian diplomats to other countries and receives foreign diplomats posted to India. What is the meaning for diplomats? Ambassador. Okay, the ambassador designate becomes ambassador after calling on the president and presenting his credentials. Okay, what is the meaning for credentials? Qualification. The qualification of the ambassadors. All treaties and agreements. So what is the meaning for treaties? Agreement. Okay, so the same meaning, treaties and agreements, these two words contain the same meaning, with foreign states are entered into in the name of the president. Emergency powers. The president has been empowered by the constitution to proclaim national emergency under Article 352, state emergency under Article 356, financial emergency under Article 360. So what is the meaning for empowered? Authorized. Okay, the president has been authorized by the constitution. What is the meaning for proclaim? Announce. To announce national emergency. So this is nothing but he has a right to announce the national emergency, state and emergency, and financial emergency. Kerala and Punjab are the states where the president rules was imposed for maximum number of times. So these two states where the president rule was imposed for the maximum number of times. So how many years? 9 times. Okay, how many times? 9 times. Removal of the president. The president may, by writing under his hand address to the vice president, resign his office. He can write his own letter and he will give it to the vice president and he may resign from the office. The president may, for violation of the constitution, he be removed from office by impeachment in the manner provided in Article 61. Impeachment is nothing but misbehavior. The impeachment action can be brought about in the form of resolution in either house of the parliament. It must be supported by not less than 1/4 of the total strength of the house for its introduction. So this impeachment must be supported by not less than 1/4. So 1/4 people agreed for this impeachment. The president shall, in spite of conclusion of his term, continue to hold office until his successor enters upon his office. So he may continue his office until when his successor enters upon his office. Thank you.